According to Hippocrates, the Greek physician, popularly recognized as the father of modern medicine, I quote, "The natural healing force within each one of us is the greatest force in getting well." The renowned cell biologist, Standard University, earlier, whom I had the privilege of meeting here, Bruce Lipton, says, I quote, "If we could get our subconscious mind to agree with our conscious mind about being happy, that is when our positive thoughts work." He also said, "In a universe made out of energy, everything is entangled. Everything is ultimately one, energy." A dear friend of mine, a bold and brilliant thinker, Dr. B.M. Hegde, Padma Bhushan, FRCS, former Vice Chancellor of Manipal University, says, I quote, "Auto-healing akin to quantum healing can bring a sick person back to normal. This alone can be called a cure." I would also like to quote a global personality, Deepak Chopra, who is among the most popular alternative medicine practitioners alive today. I quote, "Quantum healing is healing the body mind from a quantum level. That means from a level which is not manifest at a sensory level. Our bodies ultimately are fields of information, intelligence, and energy. Quantum healing involves a shift in the fields of energy information so as to bring about a correction in an idea that has gone wrong. So quantum healing involves healing one mode of consciousness, mind, to bring about changes in another mode of consciousness, that is the body. If you consciously let your body take care of you, it will become your greatest ally and trusted partner. So quantum healing is a pseudo-scientific mixture of various ideas and theories on the subject. Quantum healing is a pseudo-scientific mixture of ideas drawing on quantum mechanics, psychology and philosophy, and natural physiology that purports that quantum phenomena are responsible for health and our well-being. Quantum healing ideas include wave-particle duality, virtual particles, energy and vibrations. It's a form of alternative medicine without medicine. First, we must acknowledge that at the subatomic level, all is energy. This energy can convert to mass or to information. Healing information is our interest in quantum healing. Next, we must have full understanding of our bodies that make up the whole. The physical body is easy to understand and explain. It is one we most identify with and is generally interpreted by the senses and the brain, modified by the mind. The vital body is made up of blueprints for making form for biological functions. The vital or energy body is best treated with energy medicine such as many, including acupuncture, frequency specific micro currents, acupressure, chakra, homeopathic medicine, etc., etc. This treatment of the vital body takes longer for a cure and there are no side effects. That is a great advantage. The mind or mental body is the most powerful healer of all. The placebo effect, the phenomena where the mind heals the body because it believes in the practitioner. It was in mid-20th century, quantum physicists first identified this energy field, which lies at the heart of all existence. Science identified it as an omnipresent energetic superstructure, and they called it the zero-point field. Understanding and utilizing the zero-point field can be the key to the resolution of a condition which traditional medicine gives up as incurable. At our most fundamental level, the human body and the human mind are not separate from the rest of our environment. Everything that is comprised of energy, so in actuality, we are this energy, which is vibrating in such a way that it differentiates us as human instead of a table or any number of other things we see in our everyday lives. It was not until the mid-20th century that quantum physicists first identified this energy field, which seemed to lie at the heart of our existence. Science identified it as an omnipresent energetic substructure. They also called it as zero-point field. Everything in our universe, no matter what its size, is part of and is comprised of the quantum field. Matter itself is made of waves, accepted by science today. All matter in the universe is interconnected as and by quantum waves which have no boundary. They are infinite. The quantum field is the scientific basis of oneness. It is limitless. Harnessing quantum energy would mean incredible advancement for our worldview, our technology, our cosmology, and our knowledge of existence and reality. The exploration of the quantum field has the potential of eventually unifying science and spirituality. This means we create reality through our consciousness and therefore thoughts, which gives us the inherent yet not fully realized ability to make anything exactly as we wish it to be, including ourselves. Our consciousness and the thoughts we think can determine what our body becomes. This is in fact the reason for the placebo effect. The quantum field affects living organisms by restoring equilibrium and helping the body to achieve homeostasis. It helps restore our vitality. The quantum field, when activated with intention, can actually create what some would call miracles. For example, if a person has been diagnosed with terminal cancer, there are experts here who say, and I know they have cancer, cured cancer also. For example, if a person has been diagnosed with terminal cancer, the condition is usually addressed from purely the Newtonian physics modality of treating the tangible physical symptom. According to this modality, it is seen as an incurable disease. But if the same problem is addressed from a modality which utilizes the quantum field using intention, it can be as good as rewriting the blueprint of that person's body. You can rewrite the energetic blueprint of that person's body by deactivating the frequencies within the body which are causing the cancer in the first place, and this can lead to complete remission of a condition which traditional medicine called incurable. So it is time that the mainstream scientific and medical community focused more of their attention on quantum technologies, especially ones which relate to healing. The quantum field is the new frontier of medicine. Healing modalities which incorporate a quantum field approach will prove to be widely successful, and soon quantum field energy will be widely understood by the society. It will be recognized as one of the greatest leaps in understanding of mankind as a whole. I am going to quote from my dear friend Dr. B.M. Hegde. If he had been born in any other country, perhaps he would have got a Nobel Prize long back. I just spoke to him this afternoon. He was very happy that I am quoting, because inimitable words. Just as an atom has the blueprint of a molecule to rebuild it, the human mind has a blueprint of the entire human body. When the body needs to be rebuilt differently, the mind could do that each time we oscillate between energy, which is formless, and particle. It happens innumerable times in a second. We should have total control over what we want, with our attention to manifest out of the energy field the next moment. It depends on our belief and feelings to an extent. I repeat, it depends on our belief and feelings to an extent. Even an atheist could do that when he is in trouble, as he will hang on to the last straw while drowning. You know the famous Hollywood star Rock Hudson, who suffered from AIDS and died ultimately. Rock Hudson was caught by the paparazzi, the news media, sneaking into Lourdes in his final stage of AIDS. You know, Lourdes, supposedly, the Lourdes water is supposed to heal. They thought he didn't believe in it. They said, how did you come to Lourdes for the holy water? They asked him how he, once the president of the American Rationalist Society, could believe Lourdes water could save him. He replied, I quote, when it comes to you, you swallow your skepticism. Quantum healing is what happens when our own volition can make it happen. During the oscillation between matter and energy, to rebuild the damaged part. This needs that level of consciousness when one is very tranquil. This is where meditation and such activities have therapeutic value. Studies have shown mindful meditation can even lengthen the telomeres, which otherwise shorten with age. You know, the longer the telomeres, you live longer. Once you get shortened, your life gets shortened. I repeat, this is where meditation and such activities have therapeutic value. Studies have shown mindful meditation can even lengthen the telomeres, which otherwise shorten with age. They are shown to even change gene penetrance by altering the environment needed for it. Epigenetics brings evolution closer to human consciousness. We might have to elevate our consciousness, that is our mind, to that level where we get an insight to heal ourselves. The time is not far when we get a headache, we will have to sit in a quiet corner to meditate. To elevate our consciousness, to get total relief from headache instead of consuming the so-called painkiller pills. What we know can be held, Dr. Hegde concludes, is published in the British magazine, medical magazine. What we know can be held in the palm of one's hand, while what we do not know comes to the size of the universe. Western reductionist science admits that only 5% of this world's energy and matter are known to humans. The remaining 95% is occult. To quote Bruce Lipton again, he has written an entire beautiful book and he himself gave it to me when he came. I quote, if the brain expects that a treatment will work, please listen. He says he's done a lot of research. He left his job in Stanford University only exploring this. And he's written, if the brain expects that a treatment will work, it sends healing chemicals into the bloodstream, which facilitates healing. And the opposite is equally true and equally powerful. When the brain expects that a therapy will not work, it does not. It is called nocebo effect, says Bruce Lipton. Like placebo, heals. Nocebo means will not work. Now, recently we had an international conference on quantum healing in the Pyramid Valley of Bangalore. Eminent personalities came from all over the world. All of them are highly qualified allopathic modern medical doctors. They said, they made a statement, I remember that. He said, the future will be dominated by quantum medicine. It's a question of, he says, maybe 10 to 20 years' time. Now, about our eminent panelists today, I'm grateful to Dr. Srinivas Murthy. REMED is a sustainable and scalable enterprise that has significant role in healthcare sector with tremendous impact on social and economic conditions of the country. If someone looks for expert advice and ethical treatment in non-surgical management of chronic neck, back, knee pain, frozen shoulder, neuromuscular, neurological, and neuropsychiatric conditions, REMED is the designated center for excellence. He will explain to you what it is and how he has been working on that now. India is a country with 1.35 billion population, huge market for therapeutic lasers, which is introducing as part of regenerative medicine. We have done, they have done enough work in the sector last 6 years. So I will, Dr. Sandeep Basin, when he comes. Yes, come. Oh, doctor, come, come. Sorry, I didn't notice you were coming in. Please come, thank you. He's a renowned, he's a craniosacral therapist in New Delhi. Carewell Medical Center, India, is an exclusive natural therapy center that comes with ultimate services and amenities, crafting a spiritual connection to the mind, body and soul. The therapies provided at this clinic are considered as a beneficial alternative, especially when it comes to deal with severe disorders like heart diseases, suffering from problems like slip disc or facing crucial knee problem. And I will request Dr. Srinivas Murthy and Dr. Basin to introduce themselves in a little more clarity before they make the presentations now. So I think they're going to talk about Reiki practitioners are here, some of them, many. There are some healers here, I know already. I've described it as a turbocharging lens to run energy, reduce people's pain. So for both professionals and lay people, quantum touch is an invaluable tool. Using only a slight touch while employing breathing and body awareness techniques, one can profoundly accelerate the body's own healing response. Quantum touch practitioners generate a very high level of vibration in their hands using breathing and body awareness techniques, which creates a powerful field of revitalizing and healing energy. Last but not least, Dr. B.K. Chandrasekhar, who is already known to most of us here. He is a very highly qualified person, BA, MSc, MSc, a PhD at alternative medicine, created Guinness World Record holder in education category and all that. He is a real combination of energy and alertness. And he healed himself of three deadly diseases, cancer, hepatitis C, and what is the other thing, doctor?
Cirrhosis of the liver.
Ex-Air Force officer, and all that, I think better you hear from them. And Guinness World Records, as I told you, has written several books. Only one I will tell about that. That is, he has written a book on Supreme Doctor, the ultimate source of integrated medicine. That is the title. 3 years back, I think in the same platform, IAC, okay, 3rd August, yes. With my foreword, we released the book. And something happened, he will tell why Apollo Hospital got interested in publishing the book. And that was published through the Times of India publication. I am told Times of India publication will accept only books with a lot of credibility. And also someone has to sponsor paying 10 lakhs of rupees. Apollo Hospital sponsored, gave 10 lakhs of rupees to Times of India. 10,000 copies were printed. That's all gone. It's gone for the second print. The rest of them, they will tell. I don't want to stand between you now. We've got that sales speaker also. The hall is reasonably full. On behalf of all of you, I would like to extend a hearty welcome to all the eminent panelists here.